Welcome to Selecting Astrophotography Equipment Part 4, Selecting a Camera. You can select a DSLR or you can select a dedicated Astro camera. Check it out yourself and determine which path is best for you. I'll be talking about dedicated Astro cameras. When you start looking for CCD cameras, you'll notice mono and one-shot color versions. If you're new to astrophotography, I highly recommend a one-shot color camera. If you have many clear nights, have some basic astrophotography experience, and live in heavy light pollution, then I recommend a mono CCD camera. Mono CCD cameras and narrowband filters work well in light pollution. However, you can purchase a light pollution filter for one-shot killer cameras. If your weather is mostly cloudy or you have no astrophotography experience, then you should select a one-shot color AstroCam. I would like to introduce two CCD cameras, the Starshoot Pro and the Starshoot 3. Both are cooled AstroCams. If you stack these two side by side, you can hardly tell the difference. The difference is a mono CCD chip and a color CCD chip. The Starshoot Pro color CCD sells for $1,200 and the Starshoot 3 is $1,000. I noticed Orion is offering the Starshoot 3 with the LRGB filter set and filter wheel for $1,000. That's a pretty good deal. If you get the Starshoot 3 for heavy light pollution, you'll need a set of narrowband filters. The 1.25 inch narrowband filter set is $376. If you have been following this series of astrophotography equipment, I recommended a TRF 2008 field flattener at $250. The TRF 2008 is not needed with the smaller Starshoot 3 CCD chip. Comparing the prices, the Starshoot 3 would be $1,000 and the narrowband filter set $376 for a total camera cost of $1,376. The Starshoot Pro would cost $1,200 and the required field flattener for the 72mm refractor would cost $250 for a total camera cost of $1,450. Don't get fooled by the name One Shot Color. It's not like you're going to shoot one shot and have an image like this. This photo of Roa Fuki is 36 10-minute exposure stacked and processed. A major part of astrophotography is processing your images. If 10 different people took the same data, you'd see 10 different photos. As with any hobby, the more you practice, the better your results. Just don't think you're going to take a one-shot color camera out of the box and you're going to have results like this in 10 minutes. With most images, you spend a couple of nights taking photos and you may spend more time processing your results. These videos are aimed for beginners to help them understand what to buy and what is needed to obtain quality deep sky photos. If you're new to astrophotography, I recommend using the Starshoot Pro Color CCD. The Starshoot Pro is an excellent value that will give you many years of enjoyable service. However, if you cannot escape the light pollution, then a mono CCD camera with narrowband filters would be your choice. Another huge difference between the Starshoot Pro and the Starshoot 3 is the pixel size. You'll be able to capture a wider field of the night sky with the Starshoot Pro. However, the Starshoot 3 has amazing noise control. The Starshoot 3 has a Sony CCD chip that is practically noise-free. When you leave your camera open for any length of time, the CCD chip will produce a background noise. It's common, and this noise is typically removed taking darks. Also, another advantage of the mono CCD camera is you'll uncover fainter objects and you'll see more detail. Both cameras come with a free software called Maxim DL Essentials for capturing your images. During my astrophotography equipment tutorials, people have commented on different choices. Sure, you can try other methods and I'm sure they'll work. There are some very talented people out there who can produce outstanding results on a shoestring budget. If you follow this video series and purchased every item I discussed, it doesn't mean you're immediately get the results I've shown you. Like I mentioned earlier, processing your image is a huge part of astrophotography. I'm outlining a solid path to help you get started. Please do your research. And remember, whatever you choose is the best decision for you. Thanks for watching, and please visit myastroimages.com. Stay tuned for the next video, Selecting a Guide Scope.